Frick and Chase, we have the queen of country music, Kitty Wells, with us, and back again, the legendary Owen Bradley, who was her producer. Yep. Kitty, I've got to ask you, everyone who knows you knows that you are the epitome of the Southern lady, devoted wife and mother. How did anybody convince you to record a honky-tonk song?
Well, it wasn't hard to convince me. I was just looking for a good song to sing.
And that was it, right?
And that was it.
Where did the two of you first meet?
I guess in the studio.
I think it was.
In the recording studio. Uh-huh. When you were recording what?
It was when God made Honky Tonk Angels.
That first song
That's
brought you two together.
The first one, yeah. Uh-huh.
My goodness, and you went on to have, that was the first number one record for a female artist in country music, and a lot of people looked upon that as, oh, well, you've broken the barrier now.
Yeah.
The man's world is no longer just the man's world, huh? Did you feel the pressure of that back then?
Well, no, not really. I didn't really give it much thought, you know. I just knew I wanted to sing, and I was out there singing and recording, so that didn't bother me.
Yeah. Owen, did you see her life change in the first few months after that song went number one?
Well, I suppose it did. I think Kitty has changed so little. She just... her attitude and everything is just about the same as it was. She'd just stand up the mic and sing the song and leave, and after four songs, and I'd see her about 3 or 4 months later, and she'd do it again, you know?
Yeah.
And really, it would be like robbing a bird's nest or something.
Now, back in 1952, when you were recorded, it wasn't God Who Made Honky Tonk Angels, and you'll have to sort of give me the information on what sort of technology was available at that point. Could you do the song over and over and over again until you got it right at that point?
You sang them until you got them right.
Okay, because it used to be you'd maybe get a couple of passes at it and that was it.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, no, you could do it over. You had to get it all. You couldn't just get a little bit of it or go back and put one word in. You had to do it all.
Right.
And, I mean, musicians, everybody. If anybody made a clinker, why, you had to go back
sing the whole song over again.
And it wasn't so bad on records, but if you did a transcription, which you do 15 minutes, and then on the 14th minute, if somebody missed it, why, you really kill them.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, terrible shape.
Well, now, take us back into the recording studio with Kitty, Owen. Do you remember what types of things, what kind of advice you would give her in the studio about the way to sing this line or that particular word?
I don't think I tried to give singers too much advice about how to sing anything. I don't remember telling Kitty, why would I tell her how to sing? I might say it sounds like it's a little too high or something like that.
Yeah.
Why don't we try a little lower?
Lower.
In a very gentle way, because actually that really would be the way to do it.
And,
and if you didn't say a word plain, he would come tell you to speak it a little plainer,
Just a team effort.
Yeah, it's a pretty easy job.
Sure. let me quote former Governor Clement of Tennessee, who once said about Kitty Wells, in addition to your artistry, you demonstrate that you're the devoted wife and mother in keeping with the finest tradition of Southern womanhood. Now that to me says that you had everything together back then. Seeing there are so many artists now with all the pressures and they say, well, I can't do all this. It's the career, it's the business, and that's all I have time for. I don't have time for the family and the cooking and all that. And Johnny's back there bragging on your biscuits again, you know, when you came in today. How did you pull all that together? Was it easier then?
I don't know that it was any easier. I just knew, you know, you had these things to do and I just did it, you know. And of course, when I was gone away from home, I had somebody to stay with the children, my mother and someone like that. So it was real easy for me, a lot easier than it is for some of them I know now.
Yeah, you're right.
When all of the new artists like Susie Boggess and Lori Morgan and the great new stars coming up sing your praises and say, boy, Kitty Wells really paved the way for us, do you in your heart understand what they're talking about?
Well, I think so, and I appreciate the way they feel about it. But somebody had to pave the way. I just happened to be the first one. Thank goodness.
Yeah, you were there knocking that door and just knocked it down.
Right.
Well, you made history with that song, and we were sitting here thinking that was 42 years ago that song was number one.
Yeah.
And see how strong and legendary the song lives on, thanks to this lady and her producer, Kitty Wells and Owen Bradley. We'll be back with more Music City tonight.
Find Kitty Wells.